yin and yang. My name is Hiro, if we haven't met before through a screen. In practice today, we'll be doing a little bit of vinyasa flow and shift that into some longer held, more gentle hatha and yin based inspired practice. So if you need to shift anything in the body or take some time to lay still or sit, allow yourself to do just that. Let's start seated, and you can find yourself with your shoulders rolling back and the crown of your head lifting up to the ceiling. Close the eyes if you like, or let the eyes settle in front or below. Inhale through the nose. Exhale through your mouth. Feeling the breath enter into the lungs, into the ribcage, softening through the gaze and the eyes. Noticing your sitting bones as a root. Feel the lengthening from the sides of your waist increase. Breathing in again. Sighing out. And then bringing your hands and knees at heart center. And then we'll open the practice with the sound of one om. Releasing your hands down to your thighs, blinking the eyes open. If you're sitting up on any height or of a prop, you can take your prop off to the side and come onto the hands and the knees in the tabletop position. As you find tabletop position here, spread the fingers a bit wider, spread the toes a bit wider, and then finding cat and cow, inhale, open up the chest. Exhale, round. Inhale. And exhale. Going back and forth. Going from side to side, finding that length in through your waistline, opening up the intercostal muscles. And then reverse your hands so your fingers face towards your knees, wrist face to the front of your mat. And then you can start to bring your bum back to your heels and coming forward into the wrists, back to the fingers. So you wake up the hands, wake up the energy lines of the heart. And then shaking out your wrists, shaking out your fingertips. And then we'll tuck the toes underneath us and lift the hips back and up to downward facing dog, Adho Mukha Svanasana. Take a slight bend in your knees as you reach your hips back and up to the ceiling. Let your heels get heavier to the mat. Let your head get a bit heavier. Inhale. And exhale. Thank you. then bending your knees, looking forward, walk your feet to your hands as you fold over your legs. Inhale, reach your arms up overhead. And exhale, place your palms down, touching at heart center. Anjali Mudra. Inhale, open the arms again up to the ceiling. Exhale, fold forward, Uttanasana. Inhale, find a halfway lift. And as you exhale, place the palms down, step back to high plank or lower to your knees if you wish. As you come to your high plank pose, take another breath in. As you exhale, lower down to your knees, chest and chin, Ashtangasana. Untuck the toes as you point the feet and find Sphinx pose. Bring your elbows in front of you. As you bring your elbows in front of you, take another breath in. And out. One more like that here. Bring your elbows wide, palms on top of each other, and fold forward. Tucking the toes, press back up to your hands and your knees, maybe a back up the plank, and then send your hips back to downward dog. From there, we'll inhale and reach the right leg back. Bend the right knee and stack the right hip on the left as you point the right toes, and then reach up through your hips. Inhale. As you exhale, bring your knee back into your chest. Step the right foot to the right thumb, lower your left knee to the mat, and reach your arms up for a low lunge. Sitting into that right thigh a little bit more, lengthen your tailbone back, tipping the pelvis slightly forward. Exhale, release your right and your left hand down on either side, and then step your left foot forward. Inhale, halfway lift. And exhale, forward fold. Step back, cycle through. Lower down to your knees, chest, and chin. Inhale, this time in the cobra position, or high cobra. Keep the chest high as you lift forward. And exhale, fold forward and down. Tuck the toes, press back up the plank. Tuck the toes and lift back the down dog. Inhale, reach your left leg back. Bending the left knee, stack the hips over for three-legged dog on the second side. Keep your arms strong and firm. Now exhale, bring your knee into your chest. Stepping the foot forward, lower the right knee down, and reach the arms up for a low lunge on the second side. You might try to play with the right toes untucked as well. From there, keep reaching up through your waistline, up through your fingertips, breathing into your right thigh. So bring your hands down to either side, step your right foot forward and hold. Nice. From there, take your right hand outside your left leg and shin. Left hand comes to the low back as you bend the right knee. Straighten the left leg and turn open towards the left side. Good. Inhale, reach the arms up. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Take your peace fingers on your big, underneath the big toes and your thumbs around the peace fingers. Bending the elbows wide, bow your chest to your thighs. Inhale. Exhale. Sole of the foot, fingers towards the wrists, and then bend your knees as you hinge and fold into yourself. Breathe in.
your hands in front of your feet and inhale, halfway lift. And exhale, sit into chair pose, Utkatasana. Reach your arms forwards and up, sinking your hips back and down. Behind your back with your thumb and pointer fingers straight, reach your arms back. As you exhale, we'll twist over towards the right. Left hand to right leg, right hand on the low back. Straighten your right leg, bend your left knee, and open up to the right. To our hands and our knees here, bending a few more rounds of cat and cow. Inhale and exhale. Breathe in, breathe out. Come back to neutral and then come over to your shift forward into a Ashtangasana, chest and chin come down. Pointing your toes back, sliding into Sphinx pose once again here. Breathing in. And breathing out. Transitioning into more of our yin style practice. Longer holds here. Carefully stack the palms, widen the elbows down as you come on down. And breathe into your belly. Exhale. From there, go ahead and roll onto your back. As you roll into your back, go ahead and find the top of a block or something to prop. As you lift your hips, press your feet down, lift your hips and take a block beneath your sacrum. And then take the right outer edge of the foot over top of the left thigh, above the knee, as you come into a thread the needle position. You can bring your left shin parallel to the floor if you like. And then your hands can come behind the thigh or in front of the shin. One more breath like this. And then begin to switch across the legs the other way. More breaths here. And carefully releasing your feet to the floor. Lift your hips from your block to the side. Hug your knees into your chest. Take your hands to your shins and your ankles as you flex your feet up to the ceiling, pulling your hands down your legs but keeping your shoulders and your back of your head intact with the mat. One more breath here before we take Shavasana. And slowly release. If you have a bolster or something to place beneath your legs for your Shavasana, please feel welcome to take that if you like. Stretch your arms down your back, down your sides, and then you might take an eye pillow along for the roll, for the road, over the forehead, but away from the eyes. You don't want to cause any pain or overbearing weight on the eyelids, but enough to cover the light to tune inward. to come back into a fuller breath through the whole body. Sigh through your mouth. Wiggling the fingers and the toes, wrists and ankles. Removing the eye cover if you have it in use and hug the knees into the chest. Rolling to your side in fetal position and pressing down through the hands and the arms to come up to seated. Bring your hands to heart center. Inhale. I thank you for taking the time to show up for yourself and to give back and fill yourself up. Every little bit counts. Namaste.